I was lost after college, failed the law school exam, worked 60 hours a week, hated my job, and most importantly, I felt stuck. This is a story of how I became a data analyst and got my first data analyst job. I did it without a computer science degree, and I'm going to tell you exactly how I got the job and what I did. After college, I was working as a consultant. Little did I know that the consulting life includes zero work-life balance, 3-hour commutes, and working over 60 hours a week and having to cancel plans with friends for work. After doing this for years, I realized I needed a career where I had more control over my life and a career that I found challenging. That's when my friend mentioned a remote data analyst job, and I didn't know quite what a data analyst was, but I saw the word remote and thought this was a job that I could do. So how did I become a data analyst? The first thing I did was I identified my skill gap. I looked at the job description of the data analyst and figured out what skills did I already have and what skills do I need to start studying. Here's the original job description of the job I was applying for. Coming from a non-technical background, I definitely didn't have the SQL skills, the database knowledge, nor did I have the healthcare skill set. But I did have transferable skills like being able to present my findings and make recommendations to leadership. So I started to fill in the gaps by studying, and this is where I sat down and started time blocking my calendar. I set 4 hours a day every day dedicated to studying. I started with the resources W3 Schools and Data Camp to start learning SQL. And after practicing the syntax for a week, I found that I could get the hang of using select statements, from, where, and conditional statements that allowed me to start writing SQL. But the problem was, this wasn't enough for me to know how to use SQL for data analysis. All I could do was write code, but didn't know how to use it. This is when I realized I need to find opportunities to use SQL on the job, and I decided that I would start using it at work. The next step is to get hands-on experience. As a consultant, I had access to claims data as I was working in the litigation industry, and so I decided to take this data and automate a report that would tell me high level the total claims and the total dollars from the little data that I had. I was able to start connecting the dots just by applying my skill set and learning how I could use SQL and Excel to start doing data analysis. I also knew that I needed to gain some database knowledge. This is where I worked closely with the tech team at work, who all had a computer science background that I didn't. I shadowed the people who had these technical backgrounds at work, and they basically mentored me. Anytime I had questions about how to create a data table or to load new data, rather than asking the tech team to do it, I would do it myself. And this process allowed me to start really understanding some of the fundamentals of a database and get some experience that I could use later on in my interviews. Now that I had some hands-on experience, I updated my resume to be more technical and include this new data experience that I had. I completely changed my resume to read like a data analyst resume rather than a consultant resume. I added all my technical skills at the top, including SQL and my database knowledge, and I took the job description and started using that as bullet points under my experience, showcasing that I had a lot of the similar experiences and skills to do this data analyst job. As I was filling in my resume, I didn't have a healthcare background. I actually didn't have much healthcare knowledge, but I did have a lot of the technical skills that were required. And I think just by highlighting my transferable soft skills and making it really visible that I had a lot of the skill sets, I was able to get an interview scheduled for this role. So the next thing I did was prepare for the interviews. I knew I'd have to do a technical assessment, so I started practicing LeetCode, and by doing this, I felt more prepared for the interview, and also it helped calm my nerves to be able to do these SQL questions and answer the interview questions on the spot. After 2 weeks of practicing every day and 2 rounds of interviews with a SQL assessment, I was offered the job. Hindsight, what really helped me land this role was the fact that I was able to get hands-on data work and the fact that I had mentors help me along the way. If you're thinking about a data analyst career but have no idea where to start, you're going to love Career Foundry's career change programs. Career Foundry offers a data analytics program that is flexible, online, and will take you from complete beginner all the way to job ready. They have a job guarantee, as in, if you don't get a job within 6 months of graduating, you will get your money back. You'll have a professional portfolio by the end of the program, and you will have not only one, but two dedicated mentors who are industry experts and help you along the way. I am so excited to partner with them to announce their Changemaker Scholarship with the focus of increasing opportunity for underrepresented groups. Did you know women and minorities are not only underrepresented in tech, but they're also paid less? And as a woman in tech, I think it is so important to close this pay gap. The Changemaker Scholarship aims to do this with the mission of ensuring that anyone, regardless of identity or background, has the opportunity to shape their career. The scholarship offers up to $1,275 off all their career change programs, and the following communities are eligible to apply. If you apply, I am sending you all my good vibes, hoping that you get it. Book a call with a program advisor to learn more about the program, and you can apply for the scholarship using the link in my description below. Now let's get back to it. To get my first data analyst job, I will admit that I had very minimal technical skills, and most of what I know today comes from on-the-job experience. Because of this, I definitely had imposter syndrome for many of the years as a data analyst because I didn't come from that computer science background that a lot of my peers did. But years later now, I've realized three key lessons. The first is that credentials don't matter. Being around people who had computer science backgrounds, I always thought that I couldn't do the job as well as they did, but I've come to realize that there are so many ways to learn data analysis skills, especially now with online learning. There's boot camps, certifications, self-learning, and it doesn't matter what degree you have as long as you have the skills to do the job. And the next lesson is that soft skills are more important than the technical skills. And I've said this before, where the technical skills will get your foot in the door and they are required, but the people who have the strong skills of being able to communicate and present their insights are the ones who will get promoted, who will get hired and move up and have more opportunities in their data career. And the next lesson is that learning data analysis requires taking the initiative and being persistent. The process of transitioning into a technical career coming from a non-tech background is not easy. It will be challenging and there will be times you question yourself, but be persistent and take the initiative, and that will go so far in being able to successfully transition your career. And if you want to learn more about what I've learned in my data analyst career, please make sure that you like this video and subscribe so that you do not miss the next one. And I would love to hear more about your data analyst journey in the comments. Thank you so much, and I will see you on the next video.